In this video, we're using a lithography technique to print with aluminum foil. You can use recycled plastic and some aluminum foil to make lithograph plates. Cut out a flat piece from the plastic container, but make sure the width of the plate will fit in the pasta maker. Cut the edges straight so it'll be easy to wrap with aluminum foil. Prepare a sheet of aluminum foil. Try not to touch the middle part while cutting it to avoid transferring oils from your fingers onto the aluminum. Trim it to a size slightly bigger than the plastic plate. Lightly spray some water on the plastic plate. This will help the foil stay in place. And then lay the foil on the plate. Make sure the dull, non-shiny side is facing out. That's the side we want to use, not the shiny side of the foil. Smooth out the wrinkles from the foil with a clean paper towel. If the foil is still much larger than the plate, trim the edges. Again, avoid touching the inside of the plate. Cut the corners as this will help us drain the cola when we get to that step. Put a clean sheet of paper down first, and then put the plate face down on the paper. Fold the foil edges in so it wraps tightly around the plate. Use scotch tape on the folded edges to hold the foil in place. Don't cover the corners with the tape because we'll want to use those openings for draining later. Any drawing materials that contain oil will work for this technique. Even oil from our fingers will make marks, so we recommend placing a clean paper towel under your hand while drawing the image on the plate. Draw the design with the desired drawing materials. Different writing utensils or materials will create different textures and line qualities in the final prints, so experiment with a variety of oily, greasy, and waxy materials, such as pens, permanent markers, or crayons, to find interesting texture combinations. Cut as many sheets of paper as needed for the prints. Submerge a sheet of paper in the water and move it to the newsprint sheet. Now put a dry sheet of paper on top. Alternate the wet and dry sheets for all the cut paper. This way the paper will be appropriately dampened, not too dry, and not too wet. Put the paper stack in a plastic bag, seal the bag, and put a heavy book on top. Let it rest for at least 10 minutes. Prepare a tub of cola. Submerge the matrix in the tub and make sure the image is completely covered with cola. Depending on the drawing materials, the ideal time may differ, but 30 seconds to a minute usually works well. We use cola because it contains gum arabic and phosphoric acid, which will allow us to make the ink stick to some parts of the matrix, but not other parts. Take the plate out from the cola tub and dry it with a clean paper towel. Be gentle when blotting the plate. Prepare a tub of clean water and a sponge and soak the sponge in the water. Once the plate is removed from the cola, wet the plate immediately with the sponge and remove the remaining cola. Keep the plate slightly wet so it has a shiny surface without excess drops of water pooling. Apply a thin layer of oil-based ink to the plate with a brayer. The areas of the matrix where we made oily marks will hold the ink in place, but the ink will be repelled by the water on the rest of the surface. Wet the plate with the sponge. Keeping the plate moist is important, but no excess water should pool on the surface. Ink the plate again with the recharged brayer to transfer more ink onto the drawn marks. Repeat the process until the plate holds enough ink. Inking the matrix for the first time may not result in the best print. You may find the second print looks better than the first because the matrix may not hold the ink well enough the first time. If there's some ink on the edges, just clean it off with a wet sponge. Prepare the press felt. An extra sheet of felt can be used if you're not getting enough pressure from the pasta maker to make a good, solid impression on the paper. Lay down a sheet of dampened paper on the felt. The rest of the paper can be stored in the plastic bag to keep moist. Put the inked plate facing down on the paper. Lay down a clean sheet of newsprint on top to keep the felt clean. Hold everything tight while inserting it all into the press. Once the press felt is in, turn the handle and run the press. Guide the felt envelope as it comes out below the press. And reveal the print. Put a few drops of water on the printing surface and lay the matrix down. Reapply ink on the plate. Any wrinkles from printing the first time will be smoothed out when applying ink with the brayer. Keep the plate moist after rolling a few passes with the brayer. Repeat the process of dampening and then inking 2 to 3 times for each pull. Keep printing until your edition is complete. Experiment with combining multiple techniques to achieve multiple layers and interesting texture combinations.